Hello everyone, myself K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Welcome to video lecture on Very Small Aperture Terminal, that is also called the, in short, VSAT. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw and explain architecture of VSAT Earth Station, discuss advantages and limitations of VSAT. What is VSAT first? VSAT is a small satellite Earth station that transmits and receives data, voice or video via satellite. That means basically it is an Earth station which is used to transmit and receive data, voice, etc. via satellite. The very small component of VSAT refers to the size of the VSAT dish antenna, typically about 60 cm to 3.8 meter. The small or very small refers to the size of the dish antenna. It requires, or VSAT requires, no additional technology to operate it. VSAT simply plugs into existing terminal equipment. What is the effect on frequency and transmitted power if size of the antenna decreases? Pause the video and write the answer. I think you might have written the answer. When I decrease the size of the antenna, on the other hand, we need to increase the transmitting power. Also, we need to increase the frequency of the transmitting signal. So, decrease in antenna size causes the increase in transmitting power as well as a signal transmission frequency. Why is VSAT? Early Earth stations in commercial systems were very large and expensive. We need to make system more affordable to end user. We need to increase the transmit power from satellite and also higher frequency of transmission. This result into a smaller Earth station antenna size required. That means in the earlier days, so it is a large and expensive satellite dish antennas use, or satellite Earth stations are used. These are very difficult to install and transporting also cumbersome. To make it easy for the end user, by the cost of transmitting power increase as well as a higher frequency consideration, you can get it reduce the Earth station antenna size. VSAT implementations. There are several ways VSAT service might be implemented. First one is one way, which is used for TV broadcasting satellites, where that is the only transmission, or TV broadcasting stations have only transmission of the signals. There is no reception. That is one way transmission. Split two way, that is also called split IP implementation. Here there is a return link from user is not via the satellite. Example for this is DirecTV. So there is a two way, but return link is not through satellite, direct by the user. Third one is two-way implementation. It consists of both uplink as well as downlink through satellite. For uplink, Earth station to satellite. For downlink, from satellite to the Earth station. So in this video, I am going to discuss only two-way implementation. Two-way implementations are further classified into two types. First one is star VSATs are linked via a hub. Second one is mesh VSATs are linked together without going through a large hub. You can see these two diagrams. This is a star VSAT network. It consists of a central hub. This is also called the master control station. So there are several VSATs are connected. If anyone VSAT want to transmit signals to or communicate with another VSAT, the first signal reaches to the hub and then to the another VSAT. So, whereas in the mesh second diagram, mesh architecture, it doesn't have any hub. It has several VChats, so communication takes place from one VChat to another VChat. So VChat star architecture, you can see this diagram. There is a master control station called hub. So hub is situated on the earth station and several VChats are connected. If I want to communicate from one VChat to another VChat, it should transmit first to the satellite and then to the hub. Again, hub will retransmit back and to the satellite, and it will transmit back to the another VChat. There is a communication takes place through central unit called hub. In star network architecture, all of the traffic is routed via the master control station or called hub. If a VChat wishes to communicate with another VChat, they have to go via the hub, as we have discussed. So if VChat wants to communicate with another VChat, it should go through the hub, necessitating a double hop link via the satellite. First from VChat to the hub and then hub to the another VChat. Since all of the traffic radiates from the hub, this architecture is referred to as a star network, because here there is a hub is placed at the center. Then VSAT mesh architecture. In this, there is no hub or central control station. So one of the VSAT acts as a control station here, or several combinedly we can work together as a master control station or hub. In mesh architecture, each of the VSATs has ability to communicate directly with any of the other VSATs. Since the traffic can go to or from any VSAT, this architecture is referred to as a mesh network. It will still be necessary to have network control, and the duties of the hub can either be handled by one of the VSATs. So some hub is required to control here. So one of the VSAT acts as a hub here. The master control station functions can be shared among the VSATs. What are the advantages and limitations of star network? First we shall see advantages. First one is, it reduces the transferring of packets from the excessive number of nodes. Central hub facilitates the easy addition of new devices. Any VChat to be added here, so central hub itself gives an option to add any VChat network. It is easy to understand, install and navigate. So very easy to understand, because you can add it easily, means you can install also and understand easily. Faulty parts can be easily detected and eliminated. One advantage is, good advantage is, any of the device or VSATs goes that is faulty, they can be detected and eliminated easily. It is interference free at the time of adding and removing devices. When you add any of the new network or VSAT, so that in that time interference is free. There is no interference in the system. What are the limitations? The function of the system is highly depends upon the central hub. So totally the entire network depends on the hub. Any lapse in the central hub can result in the inoperability of entire system. If hub get any problem, the entire system will not operate. Scalability relies on the capability of the central hub. The scalability factor depends on the, that is, capability of the central hub. Advantages and limitations of mesh network. Advantage first. The mesh topology helps more than one transmission of data from one node to another node simultaneously. We can send the signal simultaneously from one node to another node. Provides privacy and security with point-to-point links. Here there is no central hub. that is why directly you can transmit from one point to another point or one link to another link. It is robust. Failure of one link doesn't affect the other system. There is no hub here. In the previous case, if hub doesn't work, then the entire system will not operate. Here, it is a robust system. Failure of one link doesn't affect the other system. Fault identification and isolations are also easy. What are the limitations? This network configuration cannot create redundant network connections, as there are some connections which are useless. The overall cost of the topology is also increased because of an excessive amount of cabling and need of IO ports. The system cost in mesh network is increased because excessing of cable and need of IO ports. Wiring is complex in this mesh network. These are some of the references I referred to prepare above PPT. Thank you.